Hi, my name is Chris Woodward, and thank you for joining me for this MongoDB video tutorial. Today, we will explore the syntax for graph traversals using AQL, the MongoDB query language. To explain the concept of graph traversals in MongoDB, we will be using the World Country example graph that you can access via the Graph menu on the web view. We will walk through some examples of how to take advantage of MongoDB's powerful query language with graph databases. For this first section, I will introduce you to the graph traversal syntax by showing you a comparison of a document query and a graph query. Then we can take a closer look at the syntax, some similarities, and some differences. Let's begin. Here are the two queries. The query of the document collection is on the left, and the graph query is on the right. As you can see, both queries use the common AQL for loop. They then iterate through some expressions, and lastly, they both use the return keyword to return the result. While they do appear similar, there are some key differences that we need to explore. Let's start with the for keyword. Typically, with a non-graph query, the for syntax is for variable name in expression. So in our example, this would be for each item in the world vertices collection, return each continent that has an ID of continent South America. Now, let's take a closer look at the syntax for the graph variant of the for keyword. It's typically for vertex variable name, edge variable name, path variable name, in traversal expression. Let's explore a bit further now in order to understand each keyword and variable in this syntax. If you were to execute our graph query, it would return some of the countries located in South America, including Brazil, Argentina, Ecuador, and more. Let's take a closer look at why we are getting these results to better understand the graph traversal for keyword. With graph traversals, the for keyword actually has a special variation that emits up to three variables that we can use in our query. The first option is the vertex, shown as V in our example. Of the three possible variables, this is the only one that is required. This represents the current vertex item or document during a traversal. So the vertices being returned in our example are the nodes or countries and capitals connected to South America. Pretty cool, huh? You may also notice that we see a lot more nodes than we got back. More on why that is coming up. The next variable emitted from the for keyword is the edge, shown as E in our example. The edge is a document stored in a special edge collection that contains the attributes of underscore key, underscore ID, underscore rev, and most importantly, the underscore from and underscore to attributes, which represent the start and end point of the edge. You can learn more about edges and graphs in the MongoDB documentation that is linked in the description. The edges are represented as lines that connect our nodes, or capitals, countries, and continents, to each other. The last variable is the path variable, represented by the P in our example. The path variable is also an object, but it contains two arrays. The first array contains all edges for the path, and the second array contains all vertices for that path. So, for our example, our edges array only has one edge for each item, that is, the edge that connects the country to South America. Meanwhile, the vertices array will contain two items, one for the country, and the second being the continent document. The reason that it only has these two documents has to do with the in keyword, along with the direction, which we will review now. The in keyword specifies the depth for the traversal. The syntax is in min dot dot max. So for our example, the one dot dot one syntax says we want to start from the first available node and go up to one node away to get the results. This criteria is the reason that none of the other nodes, aside from the ones that are immediately connected to South America, were returned. The default depth is 1, so if we had actually not supplied that 1.1, it would still give us the same results. Additionally, supplying just one number here is the same as supplying the same number for both min and max. Only getting the immediately connected nodes is nice, but you really start taking advantage of the potential of a graph whenever you change those min and max values. Changing the max value means that your query now travels further away from your start vertex. And in order to get all of the countries and their capitals in South America, we need to increase our depth to 2. However, if you do that, you will notice you start to get more than just the countries and capitals in South America. You will also get the root world node and continents connected to it. This happened because we are still using the any keyword, which says we are still accepting results from every direction. So, when we increased the max depth to 2, our query returned all the nodes that are at most 2 positions away, even if the edge direction is pointing away from South America. That means our traversal received all of the capitals and countries of South America, but it also followed one outbound edge to the root world node, which has inbound connections from all the other continents. If you were to increase the number, you would continue to get more results, which would start to include the countries and capitals of those continents. Do you remember earlier when I mentioned that the special edge collection has documents with two important properties, underscore to and underscore from? Well, those are the properties that tell ArongoDB which direction the edge is going. We have 3 options for this direction: inbound, outbound, and any. We now know that any returns results for all directions. And we also just found out that the edge connecting to the world node to South America is considered an outbound connection because the connecting edge points away from South America. That means its underscore from property is South America and its underscore to property is the world node. That leaves us with the inbound option. Supplying the inbound option for direction means our query looks for all nodes that have an edge whose underscore to property either directly connects to South America or connects to a path of nodes whose underscore to property would eventually lead to South America, such as the way Buenos Aires connects to Argentina and then Argentina connects to South America. As an example of the ways that we can traverse graphs, let's do a few simple traversal examples. First, let's supply the default 1.1 depth with a direction of outbound. This returns only the first node from our starting vertex on the right. How about if we increase our max depth to 2? Let's change our direction now to inbound. Now we only get the first 2 nodes on the left and none on the right. Let's mix it up a little bit and say we only want the nodes with a minimum depth of 2 and a maximum depth of 4. That would be 2.4 to only get the nodes 2, 3, and 4. Lastly, let's say we still want those nodes 2 through 4, but from any direction to get the nodes from both the left and the right side. As you can see, we can use the depth and direction to fine-tune our query and get exactly the results that we want. This leads to our last 2 options for our graph query, the start vertex and graph keyword. The start vertex can actually take 2 forms. The first one is the form that we use, which is an ID string. This specifies the collection, followed by a slash, and then the ID of our desired start vertex document. This first form must always be in quotes. The second form takes in a document. This is useful for when doing more complex queries where you may only want to do the graph lookup once you have a document that matches some criteria that you've already set. The last required option is the graph keyword followed by the name of the graph that we intend to traverse. So for our example, this is the world country graph. The supplied name must always be in quotes as it is a regular string. Instead of using the graph keyword syntax, you can also supply a list of edge collections. The vertex collections are then determined by the edges in those collections. This concludes the basic graph traversal syntax in AQL tutorial. Please leave us a comment with any feedback that you have, give us a thumbs up, and subscribe to stay up to date with all our new videos. Also, look in the description for a link to our graph course for freshers if you would like to learn more about graphs and the ArongoDB query language. For more information about graphs, query syntax, and everything else Arango DB, you can also visit the documentation available on our site. And you can connect with us and our wonderful community on Stack Overflow, our Slack channel, Google Groups, and more, all on ArangoDB.com.